Hey, you. Yeah, you. The girl who's pretending to read has a mediocre fashion style and, you know, with the wavy hair. Yeah, you. Do you have a physical TBR that is way too big? Do you want to reduce the amount of books that you have to read by restricting your book buying? Well, then this is the perfect video for you, because you'll be hauling 20 plus books. And there is no escaping that. Hi guys, my name is Sabine, and welcome to another video, and yes, it is a book haul. I am here with another book haul, even though my physical TBR is like 100 plus books. I don't know, something around that number. I do not really do monthly book hauls, so whenever I have just a huge pile of books that I want to show to you guys, I do one. Hence why I have a pile of 20 plus books. I even have 2 to 3 books which I'm expecting to still come into the mail because they are birthday presents that some of my bookish friends sent to me so kindly. They didn't have to, but it was so, so sweet. I have books in here that I received during my booktuber Picks My Books, a video that I did with Brit. Spoilers for that video. I have some books that I got on my birthday, and then I have just a lot of like murder mystery, YA novels, contemporaries, fantasy books, kind of sci-fi-ish. So let's just get into this book haul. Sit down, grab a snack, grab a drink, and then I will talk you guys through all of these 20 plus books. I'm gonna start with the 2 books that Brit from Basically Brit hauled for me during our booktuber Picks My Book haul video, like the mystery book haul video I do, which I really like, and I would love to do it with other like booktubers in the future. So if you guys have any suggestions for me for who I should do like a mystery book haul with, let me know in the comments down below. The first book that I got from Brit is Tell Me Again How a Crush Should Feel by Sarah Farizan. I had never heard of this book before I received it in my book haul, and this is an LGBTQ YA novel who has an, I believe, Iranian-American girl as our main character. So I feel like this is just a very inclusive YA book that has to deal with her also liking girls and how other people in her school are dealing with their own sexualities as well. That is all I know about it. That I've never heard anything about this book before actually makes it that much more intriguing to me. Maybe I have kind of a hidden gem in my hands right now and I don't know it yet. I do believe that this book has won a lot of different prizes, so is it really a hidden gem? I don't know, but I hope that it is just a gem in general. And the other book that I got from Brit is If I Am Being Honest by Emily Wibberly and Austin Sigmund Broca. Like I said, these authors just have very difficult names, but Brit knows that I love YA feminist novels, and apparently this is one of those. From reading the back, it was about a girl who is acting a certain way to get to one of the boys that she has a really, really big crush on, but in the meantime, she meets another guy who really takes her for who she is, and she's kind of finding out what it means to truly be yourself and not trying to adapt to others. That is, I believe, a little bit about what this book is about. Just in case you really want to know what a book is about, please go look it up on Goodreads. Those were the 2 books that Brit got me during the mystery book haul. Next up, I bought myself these 2 graphic novels, and I'm so glad I did. I even hosted a readathon for these 3 volumes that are currently out. Have you already guessed about which graphic novel series I'm talking? I'm gonna guess most of you guys know it, and that is Volume 2 and Volume 3 from Heartstopper by Ellis Oseman. This is an amazing comic, like graphic novel series. I believe it's gonna be 4 or 5 volumes, but I'm not too sure yet. It is about 2 boys who fall in love. Is it really a spoiler? You can probably tell it from the covers. In the first volume, Charlie and Nick are 2 boys who are gonna sit next to each other in class, and they really form this great friendship, but Charlie falls in love with Nick. Charlie is gay, but he thinks that Nick doesn't like boys as well. You actually find out that there might be something more to Nick, and that he might like Charlie back. I loved volume 2, like, so much. It was so cute, and especially volume 3, I think, dived more into deeper topics, coming out to your parents, coming out to people in your school, and what kind of effect that might have on your mental health. They are overall just extremely adorable, just a really cute drawing style, and the story, in my opinion, is very important. So if you want to read an awesome, cute, important graphic novel series, please pick up Heartstopper by Ellis Oseman. And just in general, pick up one of Ellis Oseman's books. She is one of my new favorite authors of all time. I've yet to read one of her latest novels, and then I've read everything by her already. And I just discovered her in January, so like, what is my life? Okay, so let's get on with my birthday books. This is not really a birthday present, but this book did come out on my birthday, and I received it on my birthday. And that is Anna K by Jenny Lee. This is the Dutch copy, so it already came out earlier, the English version. The Dutch book is published by Moon YA, and they kindly send it to me. I believe that this is something that I need in my life right now, because it sounds just like a great YA drama-filled story. And sometimes you are just in the mood for that. There is also Asian representation in this book, because this main character is, I believe, Korean-American. I believe that this is inspired by some kind of story already. I believe the Anna K story. I'm so bad at this. I should have looked more into what it really is inspired by. But I know that our Korean-American main character has a very comfortable life. She is, like, at the top of her society. She has a perfect kind of boring boyfriend. And there's lots of, like, drama with her friends and everything, but then she meets this other guy who is way more interesting, and she kind of has to see which kind of life she prefers. So if she likes her perfect, boring, oh my god, amazing life, or if she wants to maybe have a look at other things. I don't know if I'm describing this book correctly right now, but I just want to say thank you so, so much, Moon, for sending me this book, and I will definitely be picking it up soon. By the way, this is also a brick of a contemporary book. It is almost 500 pages, and I rarely read contemporary books that are this big, but I love that. The next book that I'm gonna hold up is gonna hurt your eyes, probably. And that is Clean by Juno Dawson. Look at how freaking shiny this book is. One of my good friends, Joni, whom I've met through Etsy a couple of years ago when she had her own shop, we just clicked and talked so much about books, and I haven't seen her in a while, which is very, very sad, but she did send me this book for my birthday. She knows how much I love Meat Market by Juno Dawson. I've talked about this book so much on my channel, so I'm sorry if you are getting sick of me talking about that book. This is one of Juno Dawson's other books, and I believe our main character has an addiction to drugs. It says on the back, when socialite Lexi Volkov almost overdoses, she thinks she's hit rock bottom. She's wrong. Rock bottom is when she's forced into an exclusive rehab facility. From there, the only way is up for Lexi and her fellow inmates, including the mysterious Brady. As she faces her demons, Lexi realizes love is the most powerful drug of all. So many people who have heard me talk about Meat Market said that I should read Clean as well, so I had this on my Amazon wish list, and without Joni even knowing that it was on my wish list, she got me this book. She knows me so well. What I can get from Meat Market, Juno Dawson writes very beautifully raw contemporary stories with an amazing message. I've also never read anything about people who are going into rehab and who have like a drug addiction, so I feel like this book will definitely educate me more on that subject. I just want to read more Juno Dawson as well, so thank you so much, Joni, for getting me this. It is so incredibly sweet of you. Also, Leonie from the Book Leo, one of my very good Dutch booktuber friends, she also got me a book for my birthday, which was just too kind. She got me One of Us is Lying by Karen M. McManus, and this is definitely a book community classic YA murder mystery novel. The little tiny sentence that kind of gives you an impression of the story is, five students walk into detention, only four leave alive. It definitely deals with like the stereotypes of high school, but I want to read more murder mystery YA novels because I have been very slowly dipping my toes into the YA murder mystery pool waters. I don't know how to describe this. And I'm noticing that I love murder mystery novels way more than I expected to. I always thought that I only liked it in like movies and TV shows because I was thinking like reading it in a book, it will just take me such a long time to find out what is really going on, and I cannot handle that. But actually, I do, and I really enjoy it. And I've seen so many people talk about this book. A bee is outside of my window, and he is distracting me so much. Go away, please. So I put this on my Amazon wishlist, and Leonie got it for me. I'm just so excited to like fully put my foot into the murder mystery waters. These sayings are just getting out of hand. And Leonie, I'm gonna say this to every single person who has gotten me books for my birthday. Thank you so much. You shouldn't have bought me this book, but just know that I love you. Hey, future Sabine here to talk about even more books, because due to all the circumstances that are going on in the world right now, some birthday presents arrived just right now on my doorstep, and it is the 24th of April right now, so that's a little late, but of course I wanted to show you guys these books in this book haul as well, because I'm so grateful, like so thankful for all the wonderful people who send me these books, like, you mean so much to me. So the first one that I have to show you guys is Yellow by Chelsea Wee. if I'm saying her last name correctly. I'm so sorry, Chelsea. Chelsea is a friend of mine who I've met through BookTube, and like back in the day, around like 2016, she made BookTube videos as well. I don't think she is active anymore right now, but she has made her own freaking poetry collection, and she has published it herself, which is just absolutely amazing. This poetry collection is all about self-love, and you can think about that in like very different ways. So either your body, but mainly in Chelsea's case, loving her family and her heritage. I've already read this like yesterday evening when it was on my doorstep. I immediately picked it up because Chelsea was so freaking kind to send me this book. Even though I wanted to support her, she sent this book to me for free, which is just Chelsea, why? Chelsea, thank you so much for sending this to me. You shouldn't have done that because I wanted to support you. Just next time, if you write another poetry collection, then, you know, I'll buy it myself. Don't you dare send it to me then. Something that came in the mail, and I was completely like unaware that this person sent me a birthday gift as well, but I got The Diviners by Libba Bray in the most amazing floppy paperback from Brit, from Basically Brit. I've already talked about her in this video, but of course she's gonna get a massive shout out again. This came up on my doorstep and I was totally not expecting it, that Brit had sent me a gift. I believe that she read this book during one of her own Basically readathons, and she read a good chunk of this book in that day. Maybe she even like finished it back then. I don't really remember, but I was already kind of interested in this, I believe, paranormal fantasy story in the 1920s. I'm not too sure about the fantasy part. When Brit talked about this book in that vlog, I was like so intrigued, and she loved it so much. She also sent the cutest note with it, and I'm saving all of these people's notes in the books that they send me because it just adds such a nice thing to that book. So Brit, thank you so much for giving this to me. If I'm still gonna upload my part two of the Owls vlog, you will see that I was very surprised when this package came in the mail because I just didn't expect it, like, at all. A sweetheart that has just popped into my life in the past 2 weeks is Tasmin from Tea Books and Tasmin. Tasmin got me a book that I kind of, to be honest, forgot about, that I put it on my wish list. I haven't heard so many people talk about this, only like when it came out, but after that, I haven't seen anyone be like, yes, this was one of my favorite books, I loved it so much. Maybe that should be a sign, but we shall see. And that is Walk on Earth, A Stranger by Ray Carson. This book, oh my god. She even got me a hardcover, by the way, which is just Tasmin, like, this is a fantasy story about a girl who can sense gold, and she has kind of been taking care of her family with her magical gift. It says on the back here, but what would someone do to control a girl with that kind of power? A person might murder for it. I believe that this is a trilogy, and I believe it takes place during the 1850s, which is just, I've never read a book that takes place during that time, so that is already very exciting to me, and I cannot wait to buddy read this with Tasmin, because a buddy read really helps me to stay motivated whilst reading book series. Tasmin, I'm all here for it, and thank you so much for your just adorable note that you wrote with it, as well as for this beautiful book. I'm so happy. Okay, and then the last two books that I got for my birthday that I have to show you guys were sent to me by Leora. And Leora is like one of my best friends. Like, she is so creative and nice, and she helps me all of the times, and just a wonderful friend in general. She sent me two hardcovers. I'm just like so excited. So the first one is A Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. Oh my god, you guys. I am still currently reading the Six of Crows duology, and I plan on reading Crooked Kingdom ASAP. And then after that, of course I want to read another Leigh Bardugo book. I've heard that Leonie from the book Leo and Leora from Books with Leo, that they both like loved this kind of dark academia book. I didn't know what dark academia meant, but apparently it's like some kind of vibe that is going on in like the Tumblr world or something. The blur here, like on the top, says the mesmerizing adult debut from Leigh Bardugo, a tale of power, privilege, dark magic, and murder set among the Ivy League elite. It just sounds like a drama-filled dark fantasy story, I believe is what this is. I have no idea what to expect from this book. I've heard like kind of mixed opinions on BookTube. So this in itself was already like amazing that Leora got that for me, but I have another book to show you guys. And the last book that I got for my birthday is The Last Magician by Liza Liza Maxwell. I think this is part of a trilogy, but it might also just be a series. And we all know how well I do with series. I don't know why all of these books are parts of series though. Like, why did I put that on my Amazon wish list? I'm torturing myself. The premise of this book, on the dust jacket, it sounds just very complicated to explain right now, but I do know that Leora has read this book and that she adored the crap out of this. I believe the sequel is out as well, but it just looks so cool. So Leora as well, thank you so much for sending me these books. And now let's get back to the regular book haul. I've already recorded for freaking 14 minutes. This book haul is gonna be so long. Now, I have two more murder mystery books that I bought. One of them I have already read, and that is Sadie by Courtney Summers. This was on my Owls Readathon TBR, so I can already check that one off the list. I have to say, it is definitely not your classic murder mystery novel. I feel like this is a more realistic novel of how everything would happen in the real world, but let's just talk about the synopsis of this book. Sadie is kind of our main character, not really, because you follow two different perspectives, but the story focuses on her. Sadie's little sister has been murdered, and Sadie believes that she knows who killed her. She is trying to get revenge on the murderer of her sister because she feels like she knows who did it, and she's kind of taking it all in her own hands. But ever since that moment, Sadie has been missing. I got chills sometimes while reading her perspective, and then the other perspective is the one of West McCrae. He has been given the project to find Sadie. He does this by interviewing all these people that Sadie has interacted with, and he is making a podcast about that. Now, I listened to this book on audiobook because so many people said that this audiobook was amazing, and I have to agree, because this audiobook has a full cast of actors who portray all of these characters, which made this story feel so incredibly real. What I got from this story is not what I was expecting. I still really quite enjoyed it. And Sadie is definitely a very mysterious character to read from. I would definitely recommend it. If you like a little bit more of a psychological murder mystery novel, I would say that it dives a little bit more into maybe the psychological aspects. Like, it doesn't really explain it, but it feels a little more deep than I believe your usual murder mystery novel. And then the other murder mystery YA book that I have, I should have picked it up already because this is the finale to one of my favorite trilogies ever. And that is The Hand on the Wall by Maureen Johnson. This is the third book in the Truly Devious trilogy, and I loved Truly Devious and The Vanishing Stare. The reason why I still haven't picked up this book is because I have forgotten all of the details in Truly Devious and The Vanishing Stare, and I need to find a good recap of those first two books before I'm gonna read the third one and find out who did everything and just all the other things that have happened in the first two novels. Truly Devious is about the Albert Ellingham Academy, which is a private school, a boarding school. So if you like that already, just, oh, I loved that element of that book so incredibly much. And Albert Ellingham set up his school for students who really want to learn about the subjects that they are really interested in. So he created his academy back in like 1936. And a few months after the opening of the school, his wife and daughter got kidnapped. And the only thing that was left behind was a clue signed by someone called Truly Devious. This has been one of the biggest American mysteries ever. That is one perspective that we follow, and the other one is In the Now, in which we follow Stevie Bell, who is gonna attend Ellingham Academy. She gets into this house with awesome students, and the thing that happens is that Truly Devious returns. One of the students is killed, and the only clue that was left behind was a note signed by Truly Devious. Stevie is obsessed with this case, and she's been trying to find out what happened to Albert Ellingham's family, and the stories get kind of intertwined, and it is absolutely amazing. I loved it so much. So before the whole weird situation in the world happened, there was this book week going on in the Netherlands. And Leora from Books with Leo, she was on one of these live shows. I was invited to the live show as well, but we also got a little goodie bag with some free books. So first off, I have Leon and Juliette by Annette van der Zijl. She's a Dutch author who is very famous, at least in the Netherlands, for this book called Sunny Boy. I've never read it because I rarely read literary fiction. And I believe that Annette van der Zijl writes a lot of fiction that is kind of non-fiction fiction, I believe. I think that Leon and Juliette is about this relationship between a slave girl and a white man, but I'm not too sure. Another book by Anne-Jet van der Zijl is De Dageraad, which is where the story of Sunny Boy began, but I haven't read that book yet, so I don't know if this is good for me to read then, but I've got it. And then lastly, we have Driepak. This is a short story book written by three different authors, one of whom, by the way, is a Dutch YouTuber. Well, he was a YouTuber. Now he makes music, but I don't know what to think of him. So these are the three tiny books that I got from the National Book Week. That National Book Week thing was in Amsterdam, so naturally Leora and I had to go to Waterstones because that is the only Waterstones in the Netherlands. And one thing that always gets me at Waterstones, and UK people, you know what I mean with this thing that I'm gonna talk about next, and that is the buy one get one half price, because how can you not buy two books then? So I found two books at the buy one get one half price book table. I was so excited to read these. So, and one of those is YA murder mystery, and that is A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. I believe the sequel is coming out very soon. I follow Electric Monkey, who has published this book, and I see them sharing all these people receiving copies of this book, and I'm like, oh my god, I haven't even read the first book, but I need to get a copy of the sequel as well. I've heard so many amazing things about this book. The case is closed. 5 years ago, schoolgirl Andy Bell was murdered by Sel Singh. The police know he did it. Everyone in town knows he did it. Having growing up in the same small town that was consumed by the murder, Pippa Fitz MOB isn't so sure. When she chooses the case as the topic for her final year project, she starts to uncover secrets that someone in town desperately wants to stay hidden. And if the real killer is still out there, how far will they go to keep Pip from the truth? And when I'm like flipping through this book, I believe that just as Sadie, this book has also kind of a podcast or interview style in between just regular story pieces, which intrigues me very much. I'm beyond excited to read more murder mystery novels. Like, how did I ever think that I didn't like that genre? And then the second book that I bought regarding this reduction thing that was going on is The Miseducation of Cameron Post by Emily M. Danforth. And do I need to tell you more why I also bought this book? This is an LGBTQ novel about Cameron's parents have died, and the first thing that goes through her mind is relief. She's relieved that they would never know that hours earlier she'd been kissing a girl. Now, Cameron is living with her very conservative aunt in this really small town in Montana, and it is set here on the back that hiding her sexuality and blending in becomes second nature to Cameron until she begins an intense friendship with the beautiful Collie Taylor. Desperate to correct her niece, Cameron's aunt takes drastic action. Now Cameron must battle with the cost of being her true self, even if she's not completely sure who that is. I need to read more LGBTQ coming of age stories, and I think that this will be the perfect read for that. There's also a movie with, I believe, what is her name again? Grace. I don't know what the actress's name is again. I really want to see that movie. I hope it is any good, but of course I really want the book to be good, and I feel like I need to read more diverse books, so this will be perfect for that. Okay, I want to get rid of this book in this book haul because I actually didn't want to get it, and that is Wild Card by Marie Lu. So I was reading Warcross and I loved the first 100 pages, felt like it was the perfect book for me. So I already ordered Wild Card because I found this hardcover book for 5 euros second-handed on Amazon. Eventually, in the end, I liked Warcross, but it wasn't like, oh my god, mind-blowing. Then I received this book and it was completely damaged. Like, it said on the website that this was gonna be in good condition. Well, I don't know, Amazon, this is not really in good condition, in my opinion, but I had to pay shipping costs if I wanted to return it, and that was like this book, because obviously it only cost me 5 euros. So then I was like, gonna keep it. And even though Wild Cross ended on quite like a cliffhanger, I don't feel the need to read Wild Cards. I have 5 more books left, so let's start with this one, and that is Love Boat Taipei by Abigail Hing Wen. I think that if I like Anna Kay, this will be, it's not the same, but I think that this will have kind of similar vibes. I feel like this book all of a sudden like came up here in the book community and quite some people were talking about it, which piqued my interest. Our main character, Ever Wong, I believe she is Taiwanese, yes she is, and her parents sent her away on this kind of summer school trip to learn learn Chinese, like Mandarin, but instead she finds the infamous Love Boat, a free-for-all where hookups abound, adults turn a blind eye, and the nightlife runs non-stop. Will Love Boat give Ever the courage to pursue the future she dreams of, to become who she wants to be? One thing's for sure, this will be a summer she will never forget. I believe that this is just a drama-filled coming-of-age story. Something about this book makes me really want to read it because it just sounds very entertaining. Then, because I recently finished The Cruel Prince trilogy by Holly Black, I was like, maybe I need to read more of her books. I really quite like the trilogy. It is not one of my faves. The third book was kind of a flop. But still, this book intrigued me very much, and that is The Darkest Part of the Forest, of course, by Holly Black. I believe in the story we follow two fairy children. What was I gonna say? I don't know if we follow these fairy children or if they are just like regular human children, but Hazel and her brother Ben live in Fairfold, where humans and the folk exist side by side. Since they were children, Hazel and Ben have been telling each other stories about the boy in the glass coffin, that he is a prince, and that they are valiant knights. But as Hazel grows up, she puts aside those stories. Hazel knows the horned boy, that was so difficult to say, will never wake until one day he does. I have no clue what to expect from this book. It is a standalone fantasy novel, which I really like because I rarely see those, and I need more of those in my life. Next up, a sequel to a very, very beloved duology. I've read the first book in March, and I really want to continue on soon, and that is Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. You all probably have read this duology. I'm a newbie, and I love it. I love all the characters. Six of Crows was such an entertaining book, with action, moral gray characters, and now they've all become my adopted babies because I love them all so much. And this book, I'm hoping, will be no less entertaining than Six of Crows, and hopefully I will love my babies even more than I already do. Guys, two more books left, okay. Next up, a book that has been destroying readers' lives ever since they have read it, and that is A Little Life by Hanya Yanagihara? I'm so sorry that I'm butchering this name. I just don't know how to pronounce it. But this is an adult novel. And see how thick this is? It is, I believe, 800 pages. Okay, this edition is like 700 something. Big books intimidate the out of me. All I know is that you follow, I believe, four friends who have known each other ever since college, and you follow them throughout their lives when they get older and older and older, and I've heard it is very emotional. I've seen all these amazing videos on Twitter and also on YouTube of people crying about this book. I especially loved watching Witty Novels' crying face on Twitter. Oh my god. I cannot stop laughing, but also I'm dreading the moment that I will experience the same emotions as her. It has been a long time since I've really sobbed over a book, and the only thing that I've seen people do when they read this book is cry. So I'm very excited to throw myself into this very emotional roller coaster, and I'm so ready for it. Guys, my vocal cords are very happy that this is the last book that I'm going to show you guys, and that is Scythe by Neil Schusterman. Everyone is talking about this trilogy, and I'm very excited to be reading it soon. In this world of Scythe, people cannot really die from any natural causes. People just live on forever, unless you get killed by a scythe. We follow, apparently, Cytra and Rowan, if I'm saying their names correctly, and they are chosen to be apprentice scythes. They know they have no option but to learn the art of killing. However, the terrifying responsibility of choosing their victims is just the start. Corruption is the order of the day, and Citra and Rowan need to stick together to fight it. Then they are told that one of them will have to glean the other. Okay, I didn't know that about this book, but this intrigues me. I've just heard so many people rave, especially about the first and second book. I believe some people have mixed opinions about the third one. I've heard that this is just a very action-packed, how'd you call this, like dystopian trilogy? And I am very curious to see what I will think about it, but that is basically true about all of these books. Okay, I'm done filming this video. I literally have 40 minutes of footage that I have to edit now. Great. So those were all the 20 plus books that I hauled today. It's insane how many books. I feel so guilty because my TBR is forever growing. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking somewhere here on the screen or on the button down below. You guys can also follow me on all of my different social media pages because I'm a booktuber. Of course, I have Goodreads, but I also have Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, plus an email address. And links to those will also be in the description box down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!